So guys, let us see about advantages and disadvantages of DBMS. In yesterday's session, I learned about data, information, database and database management system, as well as I learned about characteristic, or you can call properties, of a database management system. So today we shall see about advantages and disadvantages of a database management system. The first advantages of database management system, as I said to you, whenever you store the data in a single place, that single place database must be shared by multiple users, or you can call only authorized user. So first benefit of, or first advantages of using DBMS is sharing of data among the multiple users concurrently. Okay, sharing of data among the multiple users concurrently, that to only authorized users, should not access any unauthorized users, guys. Next, as well as the maintenance of your data is lesser, or you can call your database must be maintainable due to centralized nature. Okay, your database must be maintainable due to centralized nature about your database. Next, let me go for whenever you try to perform any development as well as maintenance, time for the development as well as maintenance. Maintenance must be less, guys, or you can call reduce the time for maintenance and development, guys. So if I add one more next point, so I can go for easily backup and recovery, you can go for concurrency, you can go for multi-user transactions. So also database also provides multiple user interface among the multiple users. And one of the most reason to use database management software is minimize the redundancy among the data. Okay, after observing these advantages about the DBMS, so what are the disadvantages are available, or what are the disadvantages of using the DBMS, guys, or what are the limitations of using the DBMS? First of all, guys, before going to understand the disadvantages, you need to know what other database softwares are available. So database softwares, like you can go for SQL Server, you can go for MySQL is a proprietary MySQL. So MySQL, earlier it was control of Sun Microsystem. Now after Sun Microsystem, it has been taken care by the Oracle Corporations. It's open source SQL Server is under control of Microsoft, and it's paid, it's not a free. Okay, then we can go for DB2 database. So it has been given by the IBM. Next, let me go for PostgreSQL. Let me check for PostgreSQL who has given. I don't remember exactly who has given. Then if you go for Oracle. So it has been provided by Oracle Database. It has been provided by Oracle Corporations. Oracle itself name indicates Oracle Corporations. Oracle Database Corporations. Latest version is 19G. We can go for Maria. You can go for some other databases like Maria. Okay, you can go for other MongoDB. It's a NoSQL database. Guys, just look at these examples. Some of the examples like MySQL, SQL Servers, PostgreSQL. Or you can go for some cloud-based databases. Like you can go for Amazon SimpleDB, It's a cloud-based database. If you go for these databases, guys, if you go for these databases, you need to install or you need to buy this database software, one or other database software. Even if you're not interested to buy, you can go for open source like a MySQL or Maria. Okay, means by observing these names, you will come to know the cost. You'll come to know the cost of this database. That maybe if you are willing to use open source, or if you are willing to use a paid version of the database. Second stuff, guys. Definitely to install this database software, you need to have large amount of storage. So definitely storage area. We can call storage area. Storage devices for those softwares, as well as those software, database softwares are complex. Why complex? Because you need a technical person to understand or to use the database management softwares. You can go for MySQL, you can go for SQL, you can go for DB, PostgreSQL or Maria or MongoDB or any Amazons or any other database, guys, or any other database. There are number of databases are available into the markets. So guys, here I need a technical SQL developer or database developer, SQL database developer to work with the database. So because of complex structure, complexity of the management about the database, as well as cost and the storage of devices about the database software, guys. So these are the advantages and disadvantages if you use database management system, guys. So now it's time to go for now. What are the stakeholders available? What is the meaning of stakeholder, guys? If I go for the stakeholder example of the college stakeholder has a principal, HODs, then professors, assistant professor, librarian, peon, head of the departments, or you can call the office head, then cashiers, drivers, peons, non-teaching staff. These all are the stakeholders of the college. Similarly, stakeholders of the database management systems. So first stakeholder is DBA. There are some totally multiple stakeholders are there. We can go for application developer. So the stakeholders of the database management systems are application developers, or you can call software developers also. Some people call as SQL software developer, because to work with these databases, I need these application developers, or I need SQL software developers. Then I need database administrator. Then I can go for end users, guys. So first of all, let's go for database administrator. Okay, guys. So let me go for first of all end user application developers, guys. Who is application developer? So application developers are those engineers or a group of people, you can call group of engineers, who are involved in developing or designing the parts of the database. Application developers are those engineers who are responsible for developing and designing the database, guys. So in market you will find database developers, maybe SQL Server developer, maybe for Oracle developers, maybe for MySQL developers. Number of developers are there. Those people are responsible to create the queries, fire the queries for specific database, maybe for college, maybe for university, maybe for bankings, or maybe for insurance companies. Next, if I go for end user, guys, end users are those layman's who is responsible to perform data insertions, data ablations, data deletions, all those guys. So all nowadays all the applications, all the web applications, all the web applications are used by the lot are used by are used by are used by a layman a layman by a layman so layman layman is knowingly or unknowingly is performing the operations like inserting the data, or you can call storing the data, or you can call inserting the data or retrieving the data from database. So whoever the users is trying to interact with the help of web applications by getting the data from the database, those users are called as end users. Suppose I'm trying to access the data from my Gmail, or maybe I'm trying to access the data from my shopping cart. Knowingly or unknowingly, if I are using Flipkart or maybe or Amazon or any other, in that case, whenever you log in, your credentials are already stored into that credential database. So what you are trying to do, you are trying to access your username and passwords, trying to check whether it is available or not. Available, then you will go to home page. If it is not available, you will be logged out. And at the last, what are the items you are adding to your cart? Those also need to store temporary, maybe in session or maybe in database, by performing the transaction managements. At that time, knowingly or unknowingly, end users are also interacting with the database software. Next let me go for database administrator. So database administrator are also called as DBA. DBA is a person or engineer or is a experienced person, the person who is responsible to manage the complete database management. So what are the responsibilities of database administrator? He is responsible for administrating, or you can call taking care of securities, whether database is available or not, or checking the license keys, or you can call managing the user accounts, providing the permissions, accessibility, or allowing the roles. So these are the tasks has to be done by the database administrator. So DBA is responsible for managing, designing the database, also maintaining the license of the database, then managing the user accounts, also responsible for roles, permissions, providing permission to the users and permissions, then accessibility of database, as well as security. So these all the tasks has to be taken care by database administrator. So database administrator is also responsible for managing and designing database and maintaining the licenses. Apart from these basic responsibilities, so it also maintains the accounts, user accounts, their roles, their permissions, accessibility, and the security about your database. Okay guys, so this is about your stakeholders of database management software. Now it's a time to learn the DBMS database models, or you can call database models. Till today, now currently we are using relational models, but before relational model, what are the models are presents, like hierarchical, like network, like any relationship models? Just we'll have overview about those models. So guys,